Hey, Sunsama, you just changed the game on how to time block in here, and I appreciate that. So it's no secret that Sunsama is one of the better daily planner apps on the market. It's at a premium price for a reason, and they recently added some really nice time blocking functionality and even like AI sort of into what they're doing. So if I click on one of these, or even actually just hover over one of these tasks and press X, it's going to try to fit this into my time block on my calendar here. So I'm going to schedule it anyway to make it fit on here. So as you can see, it found a time at 9:30 p.m. If I add another task, just as a quick aside, if I press Control K, I have the ability to sort in three new ways now as is part of an update. So I can sort chronologically, schedule tasks above unscheduled tasks, or I can do sort scheduled tasks below scheduled tasks. And then from here as well, you can always add one of these time blocks back here to your task. So it all really matters on what you want in your system, whether you want to bring things from here into your task or you want to have it the other way around. Like when I press X again and do schedule anyway, it's going to defer it till 9:30 p.m. as you saw earlier. But interesting enough, from there, I'd actually make a different schedule and edit this channel. And if I go here to Sunsama and press schedules, I actually have the ability to change the preset schedule that I'd have for all of these. So say for work, I wanted to say, oh, I'm a workaholic and work till 10 p.m. It could change on every single day of the week for it to take till 10 p.m. for it to not find actual time in my schedule. So the reason I was saying it was overcommitted is because it was figuring that my default schedule is 9 to 6. But what if for work specifically, you know, I'm just a workaholic, or obviously for something that's more reasonable, it's not this. So if I were to add a task here to my work, I go to my work section here. Example task, and hover over and press X after I finish typing it in, schedule it anyway, it would put me towards the end of the day. Now, the reason that it was saying I was overcommitted is because of that. So if I move this back to a different hour, example task again, press X here, it will have that added without it being overcommitted because my schedule says that I work till 10 p.m. because I'm crazy. And then when it comes to something like a Notion integration, now you actually can add a automation. So add an automation step. So where you can automatically have the new things in a database you bring in put to a channel specifically. So update a Notion or update an Asana. So this is going to automatically assign to personal when time, and then by matching the date and time of the action. So then like here, filter for today, and we'll look back at the automations here. If I actually have it so that it would be checked. So if I go here, just check this guy in here and go to personal, you'll see because I checked it off, it auto went to this channel. We also have the ability to add a Zoom integration or a Google Meet conference to something. So I'm somebody who uses Google Meet on the regular for my meetings because as my Google My Business, but if I made that and I clicked on it, it auto will make a Google Meet. And as you'll see here, I can quickly and easily join it or also share it with other people. And then if I added something else like this work time, add to tasks, you'll see that I also have the option to add a Zoom video conferencing call here. So if I was logged into my Zoom account, it would also give me that Zoom link just like it did with Google Meet. And if you want to see more on how to improve your productivity with time blocking or other things like it, check out this video right here.